Finally, one of the stars of the top American TV cop series, Miami Vice, was in town this week. Not Crockett or Tubbs, but Jan Hammer. He's the one who scores the high-tech, high-energy music, which adds the suspense to one of the most popular shows on American and British television. It's been Jan's job to compose 20 minutes of original music for the television series each week since it started. But now he's making new plans and can reveal some behind-the-scenes secrets. Gail Foley reports.
Jan Hammer's music has taken Miami Vice several cuts above the average American detective series. It's become a cult for portions of both the American and British television audience. But it's the Czech composer's technique, working alone using a sophisticated Fairlight synthesizer, which has aroused most interest on both sides of the Atlantic.
What happens is quite a unique process. I don't think any other film or television show is produced in that way, where the half-finished or almost finished episode is sent to me on a video cassette, and I was allowed quite an unprecedented amount of freedom in creating the music and placing it where I wanted. So I'm able to really pace the show dramatically, very much. You know, we have a great deal of influence on that.
We get the second part of the second series in the new year. Jan has been working on series 3 in his New York home.
About a month ago, I was called. I went down to Miami to actually appear in an episode, which is a big wedding, finally. And Don Johnson's character, Sonny Crockett, is getting married to a has-been rock singer, played by Sheena Easton. And I got to play at their wedding in the end. It was like a big finale, the whole ceremony. And so I actually have a cameo, which was great fun, you know.
There are lots of women in Britain who would be a bit upset about that news.
Yeah, well, I don't think it's going to last.
You've got a hunch, or you know.
I got a very good hunch. Well-placed hunch, yeah.
After 75 pacey episodes, Jan's had enough. His new LP, containing the new single, is called Escape from Television, and that's exactly what he's about to do.
After 3.5 years, I've been trying to bail out. I've been sending out smoke signals. Please let me out. You know, I tend to rise under pressure, you know. But it was just really keeping the level of excitement and the magic, where when the first 2 years or so, everything was so new, all the images were so new all the time. And for some reason, it just, I was getting a little bit burned out with it.
And I know how it's done.